August the 4th, 1964. My subject is war and the pity of war. The poetry is in the pity. All a poet can do today is warn. The words of Wilfred Owen, chosen by Benjamin Britten to preface the score of his War Requiem, which is being performed tonight in the Royal Albert Hall to commemorate the outbreak of the First World War 50 years ago today, on August the 4th, 1914. It was in loving memory of four young friends killed in the war of 1939-45 that Benjamin Britten composed his War Requiem for the inauguration of Coventry Cathedral in 1962, an event which in so many ways was an act of reconciliation after the death and destruction of war. In this great work, some have called it his masterpiece, others have likened it in its immense popular impact already to the Messiah, Britten gives the universal theme of death, as expressed in the liturgy of the Church, a terrifying relevance to life today by setting against the Latin of the Requiem Mass a number of the poems of Wilfred Owen, whose work and whose life as a soldier poet of the First World War many of you will have heard about in the program which preceded this one. The futility of man murdering man, Owen's bitter theme, was given a special poignancy at that performance in Coventry Cathedral when the part of the tenor soldier was sung by Peter Peers and the baritone soldier was Dietrich Fischer-Dieskau, the great German baritone. I was the enemy you killed, my friend. The Requiem is a complex work, but somehow it hardly needs any explanation. But if you're hearing it for the first time, a few pointers may be helpful. Against the processional solemnity and the church bells of the opening movement, Requiem Aeternam, eternal rest, grant them, O Lord, is set the sardonic comment of Owen's sonnet, what passing bells for those who die as cattle. In the Dies Irae, the church speaks of the terrors of the day of judgment, but the two soldiers think of the terrible and violent death which could come to them tomorrow. Bugles sang, saddening the evening air. The offertorium is a Latin prayer for deliverance, and against this we have Owen's poem, which tells of Abraham's offering of the young Isaac. Only in this case, the offer of God to substitute the ram of pride is not accepted, and the result is the willful slaying of half the seed of Europe, one by one. In the Sanctus, which now follows, the contrast between the serenity of the Mass, holy, 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 Lord God of Sabaoth, and the bitterness of immediate experience, my fiery heart shrinks aching at his death, is perhaps felt most acutely of all. The Agnus Dei, O Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world, is grimly echoed with Owen's 20th century picture of Christ, one ever hangs where shelled robes part. And finally, the wonderful poem, Strange Meeting, it seemed that out of battle I escaped, takes the soldiers into a place of reconciliation. Strange friend, I said, here is no cause to mourn. And to the final benediction of peace, let us sleep now, as the closing words of the Requiem Mass are uttered, requiescant in pace, may they rest in peace. Amen. The Mass itself is scored for soprano soloist, full chorus and orchestra, the poems for two male soloists and chamber orchestra, and there's a third element, a chorus of boys' voices with organ accompaniment, which suggests a world of innocence and peace which is remote indeed from the battlefield of men. Two of tonight's soloists took part in the first performance of Coventry, the soprano Heather Harper and the tenor Peter Peers. Third, the baritone Thomas Hemsley, who has strangely spent much of his professional career in Germany. The chamber orchestra, the Melos Ensemble, leader Emmanuel Hurwitz, is conducted by Benjamin Britten. The others taking part, the BBC Chorus and Choral Society, boys from Emmanuel School, conductor Christian Strover, the London Philharmonic Choir, conductor Frederick Jackson, Simon Preston, who plays the organ and chamber organ, and the BBC Symphony Orchestra, leader Hugh Maguire, conducted by Meredith Davis. Now, here is the leader of the BBC Symphony Orchestra, Hugh Maguire. Now, here are the soloists. First, Thomas Hemsley, followed by Peter Pears. Benjamin Britten, who will conduct the Melos Ensemble, and Meredith Davis. Benjamin Britten, of course. War Requiem by Benjamin Britten. My subject is war and the pity of war. Requiem eternam, eternal rest grant them, O Lord.
Thank you. Dies Irae, the Latin speaks of the terror of mankind on the day of judgment and pleads to Christ for mercy. But the soldiers speak of fears on the eve of battle, though death, they say, was never enemy of ours. They call on the great gun to destroy evil. And finally, the tenor sings of intense grief at the death of a comrade. Move him gently into the sun. Dies Irae.
Thank you.
The offertorium is a Latin prayer to Christ for deliverance and to St. Michael to lead the souls of the dead into the light according to Abraham's promise. Owen gives the story of Abraham's offering of Isaac a savage twist by making him refuse the ram God offered for sacrifice instead. But the old man would not do so, but slew his son and half the seed of Europe one by one. Offertorium.
Thank you.
In the Sanctus, the church sings ecstatically, Hosanna in Excelsis. And here we have Owen's own hopeless, bleak vision of the Day of Judgment, after the blast of lightning from the east. The contrast is total. And then comes the Agnus Dei, O Lamb of God, where Owen's personal vision of crucifixion, one ever hangs where shelled roads part, brings some measure of resolution.
Thank you. the void veins of life again with you, and wash away that immortal water.
last movement is the Libera Me, Free Me, O Lord, from Eternal Death, which ends with the final prayer from the boys' voices, Grant them eternal rest, O Lord. Meanwhile, in Owen's poem, Strange Meeting, the soldiers are led after death to a parallel reconciliation and peace. I was the enemy you killed, my friend. Let us sleep now. Libera me.
must die now. I'm in the truth untold. The pity of war. The pity boil bloody and be spilled. They will be swift with swiftness of the tigress. None will make ranks. All nations to wreck from progress.